What's up, YouTube? So the wait is finally over for you few who've been waiting for the English version of the PanGu jailbreak to come out. And it's also available for Mac and Linux users along with the Windows users. So it's really awesome. Everybody should be able to jailbreak now. A couple things before we begin. This jailbreak will last 7 days. You won't have to reinstall your tweaks after 7 days, and you won't have to restore your device, so you won't lose your jailbreak. But using this method, you will have to renew the certificate, basically delete the PanGu app and reinstall it every 7 days because of an expiration on the certificates that Apple issues for non-developers. So I'll explain that as we go through. The first thing you're going to do is head to the PanGu website. You'll be redirected to the English website, and you can click the download and help. You'll be directed to this page here. Now, you're going to need two things. You're going to need a Cydia Impactor, and then you're going to need the IPA, which is the PanGu IPA for the jailbreak. So what you're going to want to do, have your device. Mine is currently jailbroken, but it's in a non-jailbroken state and I've deleted the app, so I'm unable to jailbreak. So I'm just basically have to rerun the jailbreak as if it was new. So you guys can follow along. If you're not jailbroken, it'll be the exact same steps. So basically download this file here, which will be the IPA, and it'll show up in our download folder. And then the second, we're going to download the Cydia Impactor. So make sure you choose for Windows or Mac. I have the Mac. With Mac, you open it up and you drag it into your applications folder. Once you've done that, you can just simply go to your applications and you can open up Impactor. Now it's going to ask if you have a little switch, make sure you allow it. So you'll see your device show up in Cydia Impactor here. Now what you want to do, basically, open up your downloads folder and grab the app that you downloaded from the PanGu website, so the IPA, and just drag it to the app just like you've seen here. Simply now, just like you did in the Chinese version, if you jailbroke before, you will need an Apple ID and your passcode for this. I would suggest creating a temporary Apple ID. Just create a new Apple ID to do this. This is made by a very well-known developer in the jailbreak scene. They're not copying your Apple ID or anything, but if you want to be sure, definitely just make a new one. Once that's complete, it's going to run. You can just leave the screen on your device off. Now, once that's complete, basically the jailbreak is now on your device. So you're finished with the computer. It will be the exact same process with Windows and with Linux. So just a very quick drops the application to the device after signing it with your Apple ID, and it appears on the device like you've seen here. So we're just going to move over to the device now. So just like in the Chinese PanGu jailbreak, you have to accept the certificate. So you're going to need to head to settings, and in settings, you're going to want to go to general. If you scroll down to device management, you'll see the new developer app with your email that you used. So you'll want to click that and go trust. Now this will be active for 7 days from when you trust it. So I don't know if you want to create a calendar event or something to remind you to redo this exact process that I just did. You'll have to redo in 7 days. Once you've done that, you can go back and we'll open up the PanGu app, which the app will now open, and you'll notice it is now in English. So to start the jailbreak, just like we did before, make sure you're ready with your power button here. Now, if you have the iPhone 5S or the iPhone SE, the power button's to the top of the device. And basically what you do is you tap the start, it'll say lock the screen. So you lock the screen, and then you just wait for the jailbreak to kick in. Which you'll see here, I get the notification, even on the Apple Watch, that the jailbreak has kicked in. The device now reboots. And we are successfully jailbroken. So if this was your first time running the PanGu app, it will take a lot longer than you've seen in this video because I've already installed Cydia. If you installed the Chinese jailbreak, you can actually just delete the booter app, so the PP app, and then install this jailbreak, and you're good to go. So happy jailbreaking with iOS 9.2 to 9.3.3. If you guys have any questions or you can't get this to work, make sure you leave me a comment in the section below, and I should be able to reply pretty quick. Thanks for watching, guys. We'll see you again next time. Cheers.